Hey, what is up, everybody? Michael Crump back here again, talking about the latest and the greatest in PlayStation 4 Homebrew news and much, much more. So welcome back to PS4 Homebrew News, episode number 6. I wanted to begin with something that was a bit unexpected, and that was that there is a brand new version of PS4 Explorer 1.34. And so for those of you that may not be familiar with this application, which there probably shouldn't be that many of you, this is an application that allows us to work with different types of file types. So things such as copying, moving, deleting, files that's already on our PlayStation 4, internal hard disk drive, as well as work with our USB drives directly from the device itself. So with version 1.34, we can see that there is no more thumbnails in the slash data when you install a package file. There is the new check translation. There is added support for .dat files, and this is read-only, so .dat files are data files. So it does look like you would be able to at least open up those .dat files and actually read some of the contents in there. And the official way to get it is to use the Homebrew store to download that package. So again, these are just stored on pkg-zone.com. So next up is this workaround guide for installing PlayStation 4 game updates onto your PlayStation 5. And so at this time, currently with the PlayStation 5, the latest and greatest is 5.00. Obviously, folks are wanting to stay on 4.03 because that's more than likely going to give us the best chance to use the existing user land exploit in order to run Homebrew on that system. So if you have a PlayStation 5 and you're currently using a PlayStation 4 game, such as Elden Ring or Horizon, those require 9.03. They are playable on a 4.03 system, but you're going to run into some difficulties when downloading the patches. So in order to do this, you will need a PlayStation 4 that's at least on 9.00 or lower and has been jailbroken. You're also going to need an external hard drive, as well as, of course, the original PlayStation 4 game, a PlayStation 5, as mentioned a little bit earlier, and then there is this picture guide here. So let's take a look at this. And it states here, run Goldhen on the jailbroken PS4, and then format a USB drive as extended storage. And then you're going to change the default install location to extended storage. Then put in the PS4 game disk and let it install onto the USB drive. It says you won't be able to play it on the PS4 because it needs 9.03, but this is going to work in your PlayStation 5. So from there, you're going to go ahead and install the updates. And since you're on a jailbroken PS4, you're going to get those from Orbis Patches. I've covered Orbis Patches on the channel before. If you don't have it, you can simply go to this site. But there's also a PlayStation 4 application that you can install on your PS4 in order to download those directly. Go ahead and download the latest patch. And then it says, put this update package on another regular USB drive and install it on your PS4 as you would with the fake package. So it says, now you can go check the game info for Forbidden West. Now properly unmount the extended storage drive from the PS4. You can stop using the extended storage and plug the extended storage drive into the USB and into the back of your PS5. Insert the game disk into the PS5. And yes, this will work with the PS4 disc version of Elden Ring with the latest PS4 update and should work with any other PS4 disc game. So again, we're typically thinking right here of the new Horizon game. I don't have either one of those discs, so I can't necessarily try this myself, but I would love to hear what others have experienced with trying this method. According to the screenshots and even according to the replies from this tweet, it looks really good. And there's a couple of more images here. This obviously is an image showing it at 1.00, and then them updating to the latest Horizon game, which is at 1.09. And there it's running at 1.09 on the PlayStation 5. Definitely let me know what your experience is with this. Next up, we have yet another game that has been released, and this one is Tetris Effect Connected. And what makes this release significant is obviously that this is 1.26, and if we go and we look up 1.26, then we can see this is another one where the required firmware is at 9.50. And one of the things to quickly keep in mind here is that this was just another patch that was on 9.50 that came out for a game that has actually been around for a little while, especially if we scroll down into this and we can see that this game, at least going back as far as I can in the history here, there has been updates for this thing, firmwares such as 6.02. So this is significant because I talked about this just last month, and it was right here in this video. I said, why does the recent 9.03 game patches mean for the future of PS4 Homebrew? And so it states, apparently updates work differently than the full game. Either the files that aren't encrypted are enough to be able to backport the update, or the key that signs the update is the same for the base game. So if the base game is decrypted, the updates can be too. And this is very significant. Don't get your hopes up for a Verizon or for an Elden Ring or any of those others, mainly because the base on those is setting at 9.03. Now, if the base of a game is setting at 9.00 or lower, more than likely you will see updates coming out for it, even if those require a 9.50. Next up, we have some news that the Flow Zero has been awarded $20,000. So if we head over to HackerOne, this is where we learn and discover a little bit more about the payouts that's been given to some of the folks in the hacking scene that have specifically targeted the PlayStation. We can see right here that 2 days ago, this was closed by the Flow and they were paid out $20,000. And again, there has been multiple payouts just over the last couple of days. So right here, we have one for $1,000, another one for $1,000, and then one for $2,500. As you will note here, all of these are undisclosed reports. So undisclosed, undisclosed, undisclosed. Only the Flow or some of these other people and Sony knows what the disclosure actually was. So if you see any rumors out there saying, hey, you know what? The Flow Zero, this means we're going to get a PS4 9.03 or a 9.50 jailbreak very, very soon. They don't know what they're talking about. Don't believe them. Don't buy into any of that type of stuff. These are just paid out disclosures. We don't actually know what is included in that disclosure in order for us to make any sort of judgment call on how it might or might not affect the PlayStation 4 homebrew scene. And next up, we have a new version of the PS4 Remote Package Sender. So if you're not familiar with this application, this is an application that you run on your PC or your macOS, and you're able to take packages that is from your local hard disk drive or a server if you would like to, and you can send those packages over to your PlayStation 4 in order to have them installed automatically. Keep in mind, with this application, you will need to be running PS4 Remote Package Installer already on your PlayStation 4 in order for these packages to become installed. There was a brand new version that came out of Remote Package Sender, and this one has a couple of different features. There's a couple of new themes, so a pure black theme, a dark mode here, as well as a light mode. And if we just go up into the latest change log, which came out 2 days ago, we can see that I have added further improvements and fixes to the title bar. You can now choose which style you prefer, Mac, Windows, or Linux, and then direct view access to the local server view and PS4 API logs dropdown added, and then added the logo in the info view. So again, if you want to check this out and install it, again, the links are always included in the description below. And since I get a lot of Linux-related questions, especially on my live streams, I decided to include a couple of new distros that have been released for the PlayStation 4. So PopOS and Fedora 35. And so there are a couple of gameplay videos down here, which we'll take a look at in a moment. And if you want to install these, then you just need to go and download the image here. So let's head over to the PopOS. And as we can see here, this is PopOS, and this is running on the PlayStation 4. And if we scroll into the video just a little bit, then we can see Cyberpunk 2077, which is running natively in Linux on your PlayStation 4. And there is also this one, which is for Fedora 35. Again, as you can see in the info here, this is Fedora Linux 35 that, again, is running on a PlayStation 4. And there is some Cyberpunk gameplay that's included in this one as well. And so then there was this tweet that came out by Control Execute, and this came out on April the 1st, 2022. So take this with a grain of salt, especially knowing that that's April Fool's Day. But it says, there will be a surprise on Easter for those on 9.00 and below. I find this to be very interesting, especially coming from Control Execute, who has contributed a large number of amazing things to the community, but definitely something just to kind of keep in your back pocket and just think about. I know I'll definitely be checking Twitter on Easter and seeing if anything actually came out of this. And then finally, speaking of Control Execute, he has released the names and the symbols from Sony Computer Entertainment for things such as the PlayStation 3, PlayStation 4, PSP, and Vita names. And again, this isn't something that's going to be very helpful to just your average Homebrew user, but definitely something those such as a developer might be interested in. Okay, that is it for today. Thank you so very much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Michael, out!